We are experiencing rapid environmental change, climate change, other changes in our environments that are causing new health threats to emerge, and that as we take care of patients, it's becoming more and more important to understand what sort of environmental stressors those patients are experiencing, and also to put that together with their unique vulnerabilities. I'm Peter Rabinowitz. I'm a physician and a faculty member at the University of Washington.
I'm Michelle Berry, the Senior Associate Dean for Global Health at Stanford. And as the years have gone by, I recognize that the most important problem in global health is not malaria, TB, or HIV anymore, but it's actually climate. Because so little about climate's impact on health is actually taught in medical schools, my colleague and I have developed a case series of clinical vignettes of how climate might impact your patient in the outpatient or inpatient setting.
And so when we take care of patients, we need to understand their social determinants of health, their social vulnerability, and we also then need to put that together with the kind of environmental stressors, whether it's heat or air pollution, contact with mosquitoes or ticks or other types of infectious risks, and how those stressors are interacting with the special vulnerability of the patients.
I'm incredibly excited about this idea of the environmental determinants of health. I think we absolutely need to incorporate this into our practice.
The social history, where we find out about social determinants of health, is really where we should also be finding out about the environmental stressors of the patient. Clinicians are aware that there are significant environmental changes going on, climate change, changes in air quality from wildfire smoke and other sources of air pollution. There are psychological stresses from this rapid environmental change that are happening. And I think clinicians are looking for ways to incorporate that into the care of patients. And what we are really asking clinicians to take a look at is the history taking for social as well as environmental factors in the patient care, and being able to put social determinants together with environmental determinants of health, putting it all together in the social environmental history, which we're calling the social E, as kind of a reminder how important it is to be learning about the environments of our patients as well as their social determinants.
It's important because doctors are very busy when they're taking their histories to actually think about how we could incorporate the social E into the electronic record so that when you are seeing a patient, the zip code of the patient would come up and all environmental exposures would also be addended to that, so that it would be automatic. The physician need not go through a list of exposures, but would actually know what exposures were happening in that particular zip code. It really matters where you live. We talk about the socioeconomic determinants of health, but we don't talk about the environmental determinants of health. And I think that the social E, and particularly the social E incorporated into an electronic record, can help the physician really make better decisions about the patient.